A lot of things were running through my mind, you know, right? When I got here, too. A lot of things are still running through my mind, and I've decided to keep it to myself and be serious for once in my life. So tonight, there is no comedy. I want to preach the word. But I have a calling. Because you know I have a calling. You are the one that told me that I will not just do comedy, I have a calling. So I've decided to pick the call. So I want to start from tonight. I will be working through the scriptures like the man of God just did. See, head senior pastor of church. You are giving the exhortation as if you are doing spoken word. Jesus. When the Bible says many are called, few are chosen, we understand. He says, so we're jumping from here. He didn't shout, he didn't scream, he didn't say jump. He just finished. He went to sit down. That's why I like Accra Church so. It's a prophet. But I don't know if what happened to you happened, what happened to me happened to you. When I got here, I go join another service for Togo. Jesus. What did pay me? I forgot to do praise and worship. Now when worship got finished, the guy called me and said, sir, where are you? I said, I'm in the church. He said, what are you wearing? I said, black. He said, what can you see? I said, somebody singing. He said, that's not my church, calm down. And I went to third floor, listen to my testimony. After praise and worship, Nasa should come down, second floor, and I enter another church again. That one, the pastor already did preach, and the pastor said, wow, we have a special guest. I said, thank you. He said, please sit down. I can't sit down. So the pastor said, so it's a Bible school study. Tonight, we are going to teach you about it. And the guy was on me, sir, I can't still see you. That's your man of God is preaching. He said, no, come down. And I came down. So I wanted to enter another place. Then one came and saw me. He said, you are coming for J.O. I said, yes. He said, it's the other side. Follow me. So I've worshiped with three churches. I've received God, they come now. I'll go here for this time. Because I don't enter 1, 2, 3. I don't worship about 3 times now. That means I'm sorry. I don't need to go to church because I've wrapped up all my service today. Praise the Lord. That is testimony number one. Testimony number two. God delivered me from something that, my God, it was very touching. This morning, I was going to interview and I was arrested by the police for using an old TV plate. So I begged the policeman. I begged him. He said, I begged him 50 cities. He said, he will not take this. 100 cities. We spoke. He said, he will not take. So, and I heard a voice. I did not know if it's the voice of God. The voice now said, give him mobile money. And I sent 100 cities to the policeman through mobile money. And I received it. Later, I sat in the car, another voice spoke to me. Call NTN. You made a wrong transaction. Call them money back. And I called NTN. I said, I made a wrong transaction. They said the number, and I called the number. They now sent me a reversal that the money will come back in 10 working days. As even though it's 20 working days, I don't have a problem. But then the money comes back. So I was driving, the policeman called me. Hello. I said, yes. He said, I just cash you now. I said, me. See, I don't want to send me 100 CDs. I said, yes. He said, MTN just called me that it was a wrong transaction. I said, it's not MTN, it's fraudsters. Don't mind them, sir, it's fraudsters. He said, okay, thank you. He said, I'm like, I'm a wonder. I said, yeah, so that's how these boys they do. Yeah, policeman, you should know what I am telling you. On my way going, MTN now called me. He said, sir, we called the people to meet the reverse. I said, so can we add the man to line? I said, add him. MTN now add the policeman. The policeman, I said, the man like, hello, my name is Mr. Adam from MTN. And the gentleman is on the line. I said, okay. I said, good evening. Good morning. He said, morning. He said, young man. Say, hey, you're not doing red camp spider. I said, me? He said, yes, I just met you at Accra. Accra. I said, it's not me. I said, I'm talking to you. I'm in Takwa. I don't even know Accra. He said, no, I said, I'm in Takwa. He said, yeah, no, I said, I've not even been to Accra all my life. I don't even know. He said, but you drive a red car. I said, I don't have Uber, to place of car. He said, then it's a wrong number. I said, thank you very much. The MTN said, oh, give me my money in 10 days. Praise the Lord. Another testimony again. But you hear testimony. God delivered me from an accident. I hit somebody. No, the person hit me rather. And the side of the car, it was red. So when the person crashed, so the color changed. And I opened the bonnet and I put an hanging one oil inside. And I used to clean the car. With that spray, the car went back to the normal color. Praise the Lord. I said to them, no comedy, I'm sharing testimony. But you hear testimony. So somebody sent me a message. Somebody sent me a long message on Instagram. I was like, too bad for us. When would you be serious for us? And I said, oh, I've decided that I want to be serious. And, you know, there is this pressure from people that, oh, parent, you have to get married. You have to get married. And by God's grace, I have decided that I want to settle down. So the next month, I'll be getting married by God's grace. The first time I'll be getting married.
He says, come.
I've not married before now, so it's my first time. So I decided that I'll go to everybody that I know that I'm married. So I have 150 lists. I'll go to them and I'll ask them, how is marriage life? They will give me their advice. If the advice is not good, I will cancel the wedding. So next month, 32nd of next month, by God's grace. Yeah, 32nd. If it's not your calendar, forget the wedding. So 32nd of next month, I am getting married. You want to watch out for it. It's happening at Asha Mountains. Because I want to marry a spiritual person. So it's going to be a prayer camp. Oh, you think if I'm doing wedding, you will come and eat food? No, we'll do it on Asha Mountain. When you come here, my wife will die, we'll wear t-shirt. Fire. The two shall become one. When you finish, you go home and eat your food. Hallelujah. Now let me try and see if I can read something. When I came to Ghana Fest, the first event I did all my life, was Pastor Bear that I invited. Pastor Bear came, I think we did artwork. True story, Pastor Bear, yeah, we did at the Precious Shemi Manor, at a large. Jesus. Pastor Bear, we did artwork. 5,000 flyers. 14 banners, 1,000 stickers. On the day, that's what we shared to people. On the day of the event, with me, Pastor Isaiah, and the team, we are 22. It's not a joke. Ask Pastor Isaiah. Pastor Isaiah now came not to feel embarrassed. He now said there is no need to use the mic. He now stand in the middle. We now come the concert to a family gathering. I have invited you to come and sing, but that was not advising us. You see, God's work is like this. It's a journey that you have to start. Jesus. I said, you will not sing. He said, there's no need to sing. For what my eyes have seen, behold, you have to speak. But that told me that, don't give up. You will go far. Push out. You will go far. Push out. You will go far. I said, okay. See, you have a gift. Don't give up. And I said, okay. So when you see event, when you go do your best, I said, okay. Because of your advice, they were not in the program at National Theater, and I said I want to perform. So I now told him, he said, that's a big platform, go for it. That's his advice only. And I went to the event. If you see crowd, you know National Theater, everywhere shook. Then I called me and I came. I said, good evening. He said, my name is Parrot Man, I'm a comedian. Somebody that said, let's go. And I cracked the first joke. Oh, buddy, answer me. I cracked the second joke, nobody. After 8 jokes, nobody smiled, nobody talked to me, nobody clapped. And you know, as a comedian, as a musician, no matter what, if you stand on the stage and nobody's responding to you, you'll be feeling like the sound should go off, they should take light. Let something just happen, so I look like it's not your photo. I was praying, ladies and gentlemen, none of this is happening. After 15 minutes, and I said, thank you very much, that's my time. As I was going, nobody clapped. Act of shame. I was not leaving the National Theater. One man, I will never forget. The man was wearing suit. The man came to me, wow, you are the comedian that just left. I said, yes, sir. He said, what's your name? I said, Parrot Man, sir. I said, do you have a card? I said, card. He said, yes. And I know that this, as a comedian, it's when you impress people that they take your number for the next event. I know I did not do anything. So are you? I was curious. And I said, sir, is it that I impress you? Or my joke was okay? He said, no, he said, I just want to have your number so I will not mistakenly call you in my life. advice. when I came to Ghana first, you know, things were kind of hard. So I have to hustle. I'm giving my, this is true life story, I have to hustle. So I was once a security man. I was guiding a church. I will not mention the name of the church, but that's President's Church. I was guiding the president, but that is not a joke. I was the security man in their church. So what will happen is when they have Thursday service, they close at 9. So everybody will go. So me, I will sleep at 12. The angels will start working. Because the Bible says, except the Lord watches over Israel, the watchman watches in vain. So I cannot compete with the angels. One person has to rest for the other one to continue. So when they come around 12, I will sleep, then I will deploy the angels. Go and walk home, catch thief. Because you know you got thief got money, now you and God get problem, let me and you. So I was sleeping. That Thursday, I don't know what happened. Around 1 a.m., the pastor drove back from his house. It was blowing on. People, I'm not here because I don't own AC. And they sleep. This life, I cannot kill myself. It was all in nothing. I don't hear anything. So the pastor have to scale the fence. That's offense number one. Arm robbery attack. Man of God, jump fence. And I came to knock at the door. And I woke up. So you are sleeping on duty. I say, no, sir. I am resting. The angels are working. So when the angels leave, then me, I will continue. He said, for what? And I said, report to the company. Then I summoned me in the head. Why am I sleeping on duty? Is it because it's a church? So they are sending me to another place. Then I transfer me to Firestone. The first night, pastor, the first night when I reached there, and I put me there, I was not saying, then I showed me around. I said, okay. And it's not that I did not sleep. God sees my heart. That day I did not sleep. It's that some sleep that's like transit. You just close your eyes, open your eyes. Around 2 a.m., I just said, okay, let me just rest. Remember, I talked like this, Papa. The next thing I know that when God is calling you, you will not know God is calling you. You have to study to show yourself approval. Before I said, was Papa, Papa. I thought it was God calling me. But ladies and gentlemen, when I opened one eye, I saw four men with guns. I opened the second eye. Only me greet them. I said, good morning, sir. You people, you are welcome. See, at the security man, I said, that's how we see it too. He said, you are guiding this place. I said, that's what they told me. He said, yes, your car. I said, it's inside, sir. He said, okay, where do we pass? I said, I will lead you. I will lead you, just like John the Baptist. I will show you the way. Let's go. The man said, okay, let's go. So we are not going. So the other one was not saying that they should shoot one of my legs. Not them. So that my car will know that they are serious. I said, if you shoot me, what will you gain? My brother, we are all together in this work. We cannot kill ourselves. Let's go. We now got to the entrance. We are not talking. Kikikiki. Malgana spoke from inside. Who is that? I said, sir, it's me on security. He said, yes, what do you want by this time? I said, you have a visitor. He said, which people? I said, I'm robbers. He said, so what are you doing? Why can't you catch them? I said, sir, you said, my work is to open gate and close gate. That's why God is a gate man. I'm not a. The man was not talking. Then the other man said, if you don't put these gates at the count of five, we'll kill your security man and we'll come in. I said, oh, God, no need to shoot me. Let's pass through the back door. We now pass through the back door. We now enter inside. Oh, we enter. Everybody lie down. So I now lie down. My guy lie down. Wife lie down. So they were now saying, is there money in this house? Where's the money? Where's the money? We met. My madam was now asking the husband that, honey, who are these people? So how am I going to tell you in front of them that they are robbers? I said, madam, now your family people, they came from the village, they came to visit you. After 30 minutes, what do you have? Where do you have? The husband said, there's no money. Why is it there's no money? That robber now said, they will start the killing. They will shoot me. They will now shoot the wife. Let the wife here shoot. The wife now said, there's money. The wife went up, brought out money, gave it to the husband, and honey, I am giving you a loan. So take it. When they go, you will pay me back my money. The husband now handed over the money to the armed robber. God being so good, everybody now left in peace. They now sent me to my car. Early in the morning, if you see police, now took me to the our head office. They now query me that what happened. I say, armed robber came. I opened it. I made them pass through the back door. They opened. They were asking them, what is my duty? I said, sir, my duty is to open gate and close gate. He said, but you are supposed to catch thief. I said, well, we are coming for this training. You gave us tickle. It was in the Bible that David killed Goliath with a stone. Not now. How can you give me black stick to catch a robber with four guns? What happened? I'll be David. After they called and I said, so I'll be suspended for 3 weeks. Then I have to come back to training for them with glory again. From there, and I said, okay. I was not suspended from there, and I started doing comedy. And I made it. The last testimony before I sit down was me, you know, other than this. You know, say, I want to Agape Carnival. Man did not call me for audition. Yeah, I can see people. Two of them just sit down. That time, he was not married at then. He just called me, sit down. He said, can make me and Akesi people laugh. If I make them laugh, I don't pass the test. Only the two, not be crowd. I was talking to Akesi people. Akesi people was listening to music. He said, if I can be able to convince him to remove the earpiece, I have passed for Agape Carnival. I spoke. He was not minding me. So I actually connected him and the wife. You know, and the wife. So, as I was cracking joking, but it was happening. So, their wife was passing. And I said, Uncle Ni, I see a future with you and this lady. Say, you are a comedian, you are very funny. That's how I come and entered Agape Carnival. Praise the Lord. And before I leave, how many of you know Pastor Isaiah is a worshiper?
Ah.
Before Pastor Isaiah got married, there was some realms that Pastor Isaiah was. After their marriage, he now graduated to another realms. If you know Pastor Isaiah as at when? Before he got married, Pastor Isaiah's tongues was like Spanish. You go. Keyboardist, give me Pastor Isaiah's key. No, I'm not saying it. I'm not saying it.
Voice.
This one, I do voice training.
Voice.
I know people are phrase. Voice. I don't talk. Oh yeah. So Jesus, Badaya can come. No, Badaya does not struggle to worship. If you want to know Badaya, he doesn't struggle to worship. If you want to know that Badaya has a song that he will start with, he goes straight to the point. Worship. Let's go. This is post. It doesn't joke potato. Then you see Philip Ajale. You'll give it that. If Pataya start like this in your program, know that it's tongues that I want to start with, not the song. Explain the song for you. Worship is not a song, but it's your attitude towards the song.
Hey.
Allah, brother, don't shut up.
So I want to officially welcome you to the Love Story.
Father,